ARM is access request management. So particular setting we are going to do, ARM is the module of access control. So we'll focus on access control, and then by using transaction SPRO we'll focus on common component setting, and then we'll see the detailed description or detailed explanation of user provisioning. So first, maintain configuration setting. So go to the access control in SPRO by the following link, and then for ARM you are going to put the parameter ID 2009 to 2054, it is given, and 9 14 15 35 36 40, generally you can give no and save. So maintain configuration setting under access control. Then common component setting, go to the common component setting by the given path, integration framework, maintain connection setting, then work area provisioning, for provisioning it is PROV, and scenario connection type link, select PROV for provisioning, scenario connector link, select SAP, click on new entries, add connector group, then enter button, click on save. So no need to remember these paths. Once you log in and you will start clicking on the following link, obviously you will get to know what to do and how to do. Next is maintain connector setting. Go to the access control, then maintain connector setting, add target connector like RAKC LNT 800, application type 1, and environment, if you are doing in production you can select production and save. Next, go to the access control and maintain mapping for action and connector group, select connector group, click on folder, assign default connector to connector group, add all action 1 2 3 4 for the connector group which is mandatory. And here, after this access control and common component setting, go to the SU01 and create a user ARM access approver role. So for this ARM owner, we need to assign role SAP_GRC_access_approver, and it is a GRC user, so we are going to assign three common role, which is NWBC base role and business user role. If user is created, we are going to maintain that user in access owners. So go to the NWBC access management, access owners, this is the path, then access control owners, select username, click on a square checkbox for the role owner and save is. Now set the number range. So number range can be set by SNRO. SNRO object GRAC star, select GRAC request number, click on interval editing, then intervals, click on plus symbol and add new entries, write sequence number. For example, you can see the sequence, it is default sequence first, and then you can add and save it. Now the one of the most important purpose for access request management is user provisioning, because by user provisioning setting, end user or business user can create their request on by on, and they can see the status of the request, where it is pending and what is the approved status or pending status. So this is one of the most important thing which has been implemented through access request management ARM. And you can see in user provisioning, lot of hyperlinks are there, maintain setting for HR trigger, maintain service level agreements, define request type, maintain priority configuration, define employee types, maintain number range intervals of provisioning request, define number range for provisioning request, maintain end user personalization. By maintaining this, end user can create the request, configure attribute for the role search criteria and access request, maintain provisioning settings, maintain user default, maintain review rejection region, maintain password self services, maintain CVS setting, activate end user login. So all these we need to maintain under user provisioning. So we will see all possible path one by one quickly. Go to the user provisioning, I mean SPRO, SAP reference IMG, GRC, and then user provisioning, and then click on maintain setting for HR trigger. Suppose users are maintained from HR system, then you can go for that, or there is no use. Now user provisioning, create users in SU01 and then go for remaining options. So after that, first we need to check whether user is created or not in SU01, and if yes, then we can go further user provisioning setting. So SAP GRAC access request HR is for access request to HR system. Now user is already created in SU01, we can maintain other tags, other tabs, other thing in user provisioning. So go to the user provisioning and then maintain service level agreements. Click on new entries, select process ID. Process ID you can search by star GRAC star. Then go to the access request approval workflow. So access request approval workflow, you will see the role SAP GRAC access request. And then SLA type, select number of days. SLA days you can select 3 or according to your project scenario. Short description, user maintenance for SU01, long description same, click on save. Next is define request type. Go to the user provisioning, define request type. First, new account. Second, change account. Third, delete account. Fourth, lock account. Fifth, unlock account. Sixth, emergency user access. And seventh, information. So this is define request type. Next is role reaffirm, means role comparison. We can change MSMP process ID here. Click search criteria star GRAC star, browse option, select access request workflow. Role is given here, make it active. Above, click on new entries, then description, user request for username, select process ID. Process ID you are going to select access request ID. Click the folder selection, then new entry, select action, create user. Next is maintain priority configuration. So in this, priority ID 1 to 6, description you can mention high, medium, low, and in new entries you can select the description medium process, I mean high within 1 day you need to complete the request, medium within 2 days, low within 3 days, and it depends on the your service level agreement according to your project scenario. Other is define employee types. So this is compulsory or mandatory while creating new user. Go to the user provisioning, define employee type, new entries, write description like contract employee or external employee or permanent employee, internal employee, and save it. Now next is maintain number range intervals for provisioning request. So go to the user provisioning, maintain number range intervals for provisioning request, or directly you can execute transaction SNRO. You will get the same dialog. Select object, interval editing, intervals, and save it. Next is define number range for user provisioning. So go to the user provisioning, define number range for user provisioning, click on new entries, search for number range like 1 to, click on change, save, click on change button and activate ID to make it default. Next is maintain end user personalization. How to end user will login, I mean how the access, I mean production access form or non-production access form should be look, I mean it's look and feel for the end users regarding your access forms. So maintain end user personalization, how to end user or business user will login. So execute transaction SPRO, SAP reference IMG, GRC, then user provisioning, maintain end user personalization. Now configure attribute for role search criteria in access request. End user will see the same format for role selection. So go to the user provisioning, configure attribute for role search criteria in access request. Next is maintain provisioning setting. So go to the user provisioning, then maintain provisioning setting, select target connector like RAKCL NT 800, system name, auto provisioning. Better to select auto provisioning at end of each path, and then save for more info, see below. So here you can see the dialog, maintain system provisioning configuration, folder 1 maintain system provisioning configuration, and folder 2 is maintain global provisioning configuration. Go for this in case of multiple client like 100 200 400 600 etc. In production, if only one client, then go for folder 1. And here you will find role provisioning type, three types are there: direct, indirect, combined. So direct means making automation for SU01, indirect making automation for HR data, and combined means making automation for both SU01 and for HR data. If you select role provisioning type indirect, then below comes into the picture. For direct, just keep it empty. So job, position, HR security is called position based security, ECC transaction based security, BIBW query based security. And what about role delimit? Reassignment of roles after expiration is role delimit. Now next option is maintain user default. Go to the user provisioning, same tab as SU01 we will be doing manually. Now maintain review rejection region, SPRO, I mean go to the user provisioning, maintain review rejection region, click on new entry, select rejection ID, user, click on activate, provide description, user is not created properly like naming convention is not followed, then save it. Next is maintain password self-service. If user forgot password, few security questions will prompt for password reset. So maintain password click on new entry, fill the click on save, after save click on folder, challenge response question, click on new entry, write question and make it active. Activate end users. So user provisioning, click on activate end users, right click on service name, end user logon. So here you can see at last you can see GRSC end user login. So here you can right click and maintain. Now NWBC, execute transaction in the GRC system, and go to the access management, access request creation, and then access request. Here you can see access request. So you will see this is the access request, where request type, requested for, user, priority, business process, function area. So all user details you need to select one by one, and you can fill the form. So here risk, violation, parameters, attachment, everything is given, and user can fill it. Once request is approved, then only we can proceed. So check if request goes to approver or not, log off NWBC and restart, and log into one user in SU01 we have created, ARM owner, provided SAP underscore GRSC underscore access underscore approver role. So login through that ID, then you will get one request after submitting. So that approver, by approver ID, you can go to the home tab of NWBC and then work inbox and click on work inbox hyperlink. Here you can get, click on all, then you will be getting request if request is submitted. After request approval, now login as requester, login as a end user or business user, and then you will find here a status like it is approved. If you will click, you will get all the details here. Initially request was there. So access request, this is approved. So you can check the status of the request. So this is the beauty of access request management. Search request, you can check the request also. So thank you for watching. That's all about ARM. So no need to go through or remember all these paths, just log in and try to practice. Once you will create the request, then automatically everything will be clear. Once again, thanks for watching and have a great one.